वेलकम टू शासर क्लासेस एंड एवर शाइन कोचिंग सेंटर। इट्स माई प्लेजर टू बी द फाउंडर ऑफ एवर शाइन कोचिंग सेंटर एंड हेल्प ऑल द डिजर्विंग स्टूडेंट्स टू स्कोर द वेरी गुड मार्क्स इन द अपकमिंग SSLC बोर्ड एग्जाम। माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द क्लास फॉर क्लास 10 SSLC कर्नाटका स्टेट बोर्ड सोशल साइंस as per the revised reduced syllabus and new pattern that is multiple choice questions for this year academic board exams 2021. Now we are going to have first what we do here is we are going to cover the summary of all the chapters, then we discuss the multiple choice questions, and then we conduct the test. So this is the way what we are going to complete the entire syllabus. Okay, so here in the summary itself I can tell you, you are going to prepare 100%, because in summary we are going to teach you in and around the complete basics related to this chapter. Today we are going to start the chapter Advent of Europeans to India. Let me go chapter wise. The Advent of Europeans, the Advent of Europeans to India. Now children, here we have the place which is called as Constantinople. Okay children, earlier the name of this Constantinople was modern Istanbul. What was the earlier name? Modern Istanbul. This was the earlier name of this place. People were calling this as modern Istanbul. Now later on it has changed into Constantinople. So this Constantinople, we have so many important features related to this. Which are those? Let me study. Constantinople was known as the gateway of European trade. It was the gateway, or we can say it was the gate of European trade. Okay, so Constantinople is the gate of European trade. Now the trade was happening between two different territories, that is, okay, I'm just giving you the complete picture right from the beginning and with complete basics. Okay, here the trade was happening between two different places or territories. One is Asia and other one is European country. One is on with Asia and other is Europe. Let me say Europe. Okay, the trade was dealing between Asia and Europe. Now the complete Asian countries, or complete Asia, the Asian countries, the monopoly was gained by Arab merchants. So Arab merchants was the complete authority. Okay, these were the people who was complete authorized to deal with the transactions, whatever it happens in this place. Okay, Arab merchants ke haath mein pura power tha beta. Jo bhi Asian countries ka jo bhi trade ho raha hai, to Arab merchants ke haath mein wo complete power hai. Okay, understood children? Now similarly, the Europe, who gained the monopoly of over trade in Europe, those are the Italian merchants. Now Italian merchants ke haath mein pura Europe hai. Jo bhi transaction chalta, ye jo bhi business chalta, ye pura Italian merchants dekh rahe. Asia ke andar Arab merchants in charge hain, aur Europe ke andar Italian merchants in charge hain. Any doubts? Understood the point? Monopoly means complete taking care. Those are the people who are in charge. Monopoly, it's complete under them. Understood? Yeah, in Asian countries, whatever the trade was happening, that complete in charge was under Arab merchants. And Europe, whatever the trade was happening, the complete in charge were Italian merchants. Now what happened here is very interesting. These Italian merchants will come to Asian countries Understood? It means they come to Constantinople from the Arab merchants. They will buy the goods. After they buy the goods, again they go to Europe and they sell them to European peoples, to Europe. Understood? Italian merchants will come to Arab merchants. They will purchase the goods. Same goods they will take to Europe and they will sell to those people with some profit. By keeping some profit, they used to sell to Europe. Any doubt? Understood the concept? Now, where this trade is taking place between Europe and Asian countries? Where was the trade? Trade means what is trade? Buying and selling Buying and selling goods is called as trade. Okay. Where is the trade was taking place? Yeah, the trade was taking place. Okay. With the, I think you may have seen a word called as a market. If you want to buy a large amount of goods or if you have to buy the vegetables, you go to one market, right? Example, let you consider your city market or any vegetable market where you can find all varieties of goods in a single place. Yeah, we say that as a market, right? Yes or no? We say that as a market, yeah. Even here also the same thing was happening. Okay, this market name is Constantinople. Understood? Between whom, during the time, between whom the trade was happening? Between which merchants the trade was happening? Yes, Arab merchants and who gained the monopoly of Asian trade? Who gained the monopoly of European trade? Italian merchants. See, children, it's like a story, nothing else. Your complete social is like a story, nothing. That's like a movie clip. Now, what happened in the year? Now, this year is important. In the year 1453, in the year 1453, by the name Ottoman Turk, Ottoman Turk. He captured Constantinople. What he did? He captured Constantinople. Any doubts? Who captured Constantinople? Ottoman Turk. In which year? 1453. See, children, this Ottoman Turk, this fellow is very interesting fellow, very brave, very intelligent. What he did, you know, he once he captured this place Constantinople and he started levying more tax on the goods. He started collecting or levying more tax on the goods which was passing through this place Constantinople. If any goods has to pass, example, this is my Constantinople and this is my Europe, and let me say this is the Asian country. If this goods has to come here, or if this goods has to come here, or if it has to move from here to here, they have to pay more tax. They have to pay more tax for this Ottoman Turk. People was not satisfied with this because he's collecting more tax. For an example, you are selling a product for 100 rupees. Okay, selling price is 100 rupees. Your cost price, actual cost price is 80 rupees. By keeping 20 rupees profit, you are selling the product. And he is asking you to pay 30 to 40 rupees as tax. Is it possible that they can pay? Example, I'm just giving. They are not getting profit. They are not at all getting profit. Even actual price also, sometimes they are not getting. But they have to pay huge amount of a huge amount of tax to him. So all the peoples were very much worried of this kind of a situation. Okay, हर आदमी बहुत परेशान हो गया. कितना टैक्स देना, कितना टैक्स देना. इस तो टैक्स कोड़वे कंता, ये लार गुनो तुम्बा तुंड रही तो. Understood? Then the people started thinking, what we have to do for the because the Turk started levying so much taxes, which was passing through this Constantinople routes. Then See, very interesting peoples. What happened, you know? After that, The Spain and Portugal, remember this name, this is very important name. The Spain and Portugal came forward. These people, what they did, no? They encouraged sailors. What they did? They encouraged sailors to invent any other alternate route. Any other alternate route. As I said you, this is Constantinople and this is the route. Let me say, this is, it is not audible. Okay, no problem. Now, is it audible? Yeah, this is my road transport. This is my road transport. If the vehicles are moving from here to here or here to here, we have to pay more tax to this place, right? Yeah, to this person. Then this Portugal and Spain, what they did, understood? What these both fellows did. Now, it's audible? Yes or no? Yes, very good. Okay. Still some students are joining at this time. Yeah. The goods which has to move from this place, they have to pay more tax. Then what they did for Spain and Portugal, they encouraged sailors to find any other alternate route. Understood? They still it's not clear. Children, others mute your mics. Kindly mute your mics. Now is it audible? Now is it audible? They have to pay more taxes. So what happened? This Spain and Portugal, these both peoples, what they did, you know? They encouraged sailors. This is a very important name, okay? So these both peoples, they encouraged the sailors to invent the new sea route to India. New, not sea route, new route to India. Any alternate route. Then what happened? After they encouraged the sailors, then a Portuguese sailor, a Portuguese navigator or sailor, his name is Vasco da Gama. Who is he? Yeah. Now, Vasco da Gama, he invented new sea route to India. He invented new sea route to India. Any doubts? Who is Vasco da Gama? He is a Portuguese sailor. He invented new sea route to India. From where he came? He came from? Where did he reach? Where it is? He left Lisbon. From where he came? He left Lisbon and he reached Kapadu. Where is Kapadu? Kapadu is the place in Calicut. Yeah. And near east coast. Near east coast of India. In west or east? West coast? East coast or west coast? I think it should be east or west. East or west, India is the best. Okay, let me take west. Let it be west coast of India. In which year Vasco da Gama invented new sea route to India? 1498. In which year Ottoman Turks captured Constantinople? 1453 he captured, right? इन 1498 ही इन्वेंटेड, अंडरस्टूड? कैन यू सी द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम 53 टू 98? दिस इज द टाइम दिस फेलो वॉज कलेक्टिंग सो मच टैक्स फ्रॉम द पीपल, अंडरस्टूड? अंडरस्टूड? नाउ या नाउ द क्वेश्चन फॉर यू, यू मे गेट, हु आर द फर्स्ट टू री एस्टैब्लिश ट्रेड बिटवीन इंडिया एंड यूरोप? Who were the first? See the questions now. Who were the first to re-establish? Who were the first who re-established between? Who were the first who re-established trade between India and Europe? India and Europe. Yes, answer is Portuguese. Very good. Answer is Portuguese. Portuguese were the first to re-establish trade between India and Europe. Understood? Yeah. Next, who were the first to arrive India for trade? Who came first to India? Who came first to India to do trade? Portuguese. Portuguese came first to India. Who were the last? Who were the last who left India? Leave India. Who were the one who leave? Who were the last to leave India? Yes. My question is, who were the last to leave India? Are you sure? Portuguese were the last to leave India. Students, listen it carefully. Understand the given question. Who were the last to leave India? English. English left last, not Portuguese. English were the last. Britishers were the last to left India, right? But here, no question. If they ask you, who were the last to leave India? Who were the last to leave India? Understood? By sea route, if they give this word sea route, through sea route is Portuguese. Understood? Did you understood? Who was the last to leave India on the sea route? On the sea route, if they mention sea route is Portuguese, generally is Britishers. Correct? No, we got independence from the Britishers only. No man. Now, who arrived in India as the Viceroy of Portuguese after Vasco da Gama? Yeah, now, children, this is very important point which you need to remember. What it means, they may ask you this question, chronicle order. Means you have to arrange in an order. Who came first, who came next, like that. They may ask you the question in this form. Be careful. Understood? First, who came? First, who came? Yes, man. Portuguese only. First, who came? Vasco da Gama. Understood. After Vasco da Gama, who arrived in India as the Viceroy of Portuguese after Vasco da Gama? Francisco de Almeida. Are you understood? Understood? Yeah. Who arrived in India as the Viceroy of Portuguese? Who arrived in India as the Viceroy of Portuguese after Vasco da Gama? After Vasco da Gama, Francisco de Almeida. He is the Viceroy of Portuguese power in India. Understood? Now, one beautiful story is there about this fellow. Very interesting. Understood? He cannot rule for a maximum period of time, this fellow. As soon he became a viceroy, this fellow, Francisco de Almeida, he implemented head. Yeah, that is blue water policy. What he invented? He implemented blue water policy. Understood? As soon as Francisco de Almeida became the viceroy, he has to show, no, he is great. He is very rich, he is great. He has more attitude, he is more powerful. He has to show, right? Yes or no, man? Yeah, if I make any one of you as tomorrow's chief minister, means what? How much attitude you will be having? If you see me in front of you also, no, you don't care me also. Understood? So much attitude you will be having the other day. See, yes, sir. Understood? So he implemented blue water policy. Now, what is exactly the meaning of blue water policy, children? Wait. I'm not asking you any dictation here. Wait. Understand first. Okay. So, as soon as he became the viceroy, he implemented a policy called as blue water policy. Now, the question arises here. What is the meaning of blue water policy? Blue water policy. Yes. Okay. Listen to me first. Let others also understand. When I give you a chance, then you can answer to me. Okay. First, listen to the things. Okay. Yeah. Blue water policy. So what is the meaning of blue water policy? See, children, blue water policy is nothing but, children, this question has came in board exam. This question, based on this blue water policy, in exam, they have asked already a question based on this point. Okay. So blue water policy is nothing but to establish the supremacy over sea instead of supremacy over land. Supremacy means complete power. So understood, we are establishing complete supremacy over sea. Understood? Now what happened, you know? Ottoman Turks, he captured all land route, right? Correct, no? All land route has been captured by Ottoman Turks. Portuguese were the one, no, who introduced this sea route. Understood? Yeah, Portuguese, no, invented this new route. So these people said that we have invented this, so now we have the power. We have all the rights on this sea route. We are not going to land route. You take care about your territory. We are not coming and asking you. Now, whatever happens in the sea route, no, we are responsible for that. We will collect the tax. But they were not collecting more tax, all those things. But complete supremacy of sea over land, that is called as blue water policy. Understood? But here, just you need to remember only one word in your mind. Complete territory supremacy of sea was taken by Francisco de Almeida. Understood? Yeah, to establish the supremacy over the sea instead of supremacy over land. Supremacy over lands means supremacy of land was already taken by some other person. So complete sea supremacy or complete sea territories will be taken by Francisco de Almeida. Now, after Francisco de Almeida, who came? Who is he? Alfonso de Albuquerque. Children's very important name. And after he became the next viceroy of the Portuguese, he made so many different changes. Understood? This person came, he told everything is mine. Then they kicked off him. Go out. Today only joined the party and today you're telling all the things are of mine. No. You can't be here. You're not fit to be the viceroy. Get out. Then they made Alfonso de Albuquerque. Then Alfonso de Albuquerque, when he came to the territory or when he came to the power, understood, he made so many different changes. He made Portuguese power strong. He made the Portuguese power strong. So we call him as a real founder of Portuguese Empire. Very important question. Who is known as a real founder of Portuguese Empire in India? Alfonso de Albuquerque. Albuquerque also we say, or Albuquerque also we say sometimes. Okay. Alfonso de Albuquerque. Okay. He is known as the real founder of Portuguese power in India. He has made so many different changes and he has won so many wars, but in your textbook, they have given very few points. Just we have to note concentrate on that point. Okay, as soon as he came to the power, what he did, you know, he fought the battle against Sultan of Bijapur. What he did? He fought a battle against whom? Sultan of Bijapur. Yeah, in which year? CE 1510. Understood? In this year. Okay, 1510. In the year 1510, he fought against the Sultan of Bijapur and won Goa. Which place he won? Goa. Understood, man? Is this clear? And after he captured Goa, excuse me, just a minute. Yeah. After he captured Goa, he made Goa as the Portuguese administration. Understood? Administration means all decisions, everything will be taken, no? All meetings, important meeting, decisions, that is a place where complete all the decisions will be taken. So he made that territory or that center as the administrative center of India. Okay. Now I hope, is it audible? Yeah. After he captured Goa, he made Goa as the Portuguese administrative center. So which was the Portuguese administrative center in India? Who fought the battle against Sultan of Bijapur? Who implemented Blue Water Policy? Who invented new sea route to India? Because the trade was taking place between the European countries and the Asian countries. Where was the trade was happening between Asian countries and European countries? Constantinople. What was the earlier name of Constantinople? Which was the Portuguese administrative center in India? Goa. Who made Goa as the Portuguese administrative center in India? No, I have said you right. Same way, they will mix up the questions and they will ask you. Understood now? Is it difficult, man? Yeah, you want to go ahead, social? Then, see children. After that, what happens? See, one or the other day, someone has to fall down, right? Here also the same thing was happened. Okay? What was happened here is very simple. After some time, the Portuguese rulers was there, right? The peoples who were working under the Portuguese, they became weak and inefficient. Understood? They became weak. And also, what happened? There was a conflict between the rulers only because of the power. There was a conflict. Unke andar ek jhagda hona shuru hoga. Aur kya hota tha? These points are not there in the textbook, but just I'm telling you. The Portuguese rulers became weak and inefficient, and there was a conflict between the rulers, and also they were giving all the secrets of the Portuguese to other peoples. So that what happens after some time, the Portuguese power declined. It started declined. Any doubts? Understood? So the Portuguese power declined because of these reasons, as well as addition to this, one more important reason was there. What was that reason is, due to the arrival of English and French, as soon as English and French came to India, the Portuguese power started declining. These two peoples are there, no? Very intelligent fellows. This English and French, they are collecting the information of the Portuguese. They were collecting the information of the Portuguese, where they do the war, all those things, and they made those rulers, they bribed them, and they collected the information, due to which the Portuguese power declined. And then these people came forward. Understood? Yeah. Due to the arrival of English and French, the Portuguese power started declining in India. Next, one more question. When was the Dutch East India Company started? When was the Dutch East India Company started? 1602. Very good. Dutch East India Company was started in the year 1602. Now, Dutch was the peoples, understood. Actually, where they are living, you know, they were living. Excuse me. Listen to me. Yes, man, I know. Listen to me first, man. So, Dutch was living near islands. And actually, these are the very still more intelligent fellows, because they know that our power is not so much strong compared to English and French. Our army is not so much strong. If we go and fight against the English, definitely they will defeat us, and also they will capture our territories also. They was knowing about this. So what they did, they started limiting themselves to spice-rich islands. What God has given to us, we are satisfied with that. We don't want any other thing. What they said, we don't want any other thing. What God has given to us, let we be happy and satisfied with the same thing. So that they didn't fight against anyone, let it be Portuguese or English or French. Any doubts? Yeah, because they were unable to face competition between English and French. That is the reason the Dutch limit themselves to spice-rich islands. Next, very important question. Who issued a royal charter authorizing East India Company to trade with Eastern countries? Now East India Company will do trade with Eastern countries. Who sent that memo? Who issued that charter, royal charter? Queen Elizabeth. Yes, very good. Queen Elizabeth kya kari beta? Ek invitation bheji. Kya kar ko bolko? Aaj se East India Company Eastern countries ke saath mein trade karte hain, kar ko bolke. Understood? Yeah, very good. Next, who issued a royal permission to do to the English to do their what we say? Yeah, who gave permission? Excuse me, mute your mics. Who gave permission for English to do trade in India? Or sometimes instead of trade, they may also give you the question like, who gave the permission to start warehouses in India? To start warehouses. This word also. Yeah. Mughal Emperor Jahangir. Yes. Where the English started their first warehouse in India? Where they started warehouse? Surat. In Surat, they started their first warehouse. Next, who is Sir Thomas Roy? Please mute, other you can mute your mics. Yeah. See, almost everyone are switching on their mics now, man. How can you listen, man? I'm taking that time. Now my head is paining actually. Since 1 o'clock continuously I'm taking class. Sir Thomas Roy. Who is Sir Thomas Roy? Very good. He is a royal ambassador. सर थॉमस रॉय इज अ रॉयल एम्बेसडर, ही केम फ्रॉम द कोर्ट ऑफ जेम्स फर्स्ट, ही केम फ्रॉम द कोर्ट ऑफ जेम्स फर्स्ट, अंडरस्टूड। नेक्स्ट, हाउ डिड द इंग्लिश एस्टैब्लिश अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फोर्ट नेम्ड सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट, सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट, हाउ डिड इंग्लिश एस्टैब्लिश अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फोर्ट नेम सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट, हाउ डिड दे एस्टैब्लिश दिस फोर्ट, हाउ दे एस्टैब्लिश सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट, टू नेम्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट, वन इज सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट एंड अनदर इज सेंट विलियम फोर्ट, कैन यू रिमेंबर? करेक्ट, सेंट विलियम फोर्ट एंड सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट, दिस टू फोर्ट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फोर्ट्स विच वॉज बिल्ड बाई द ब्रिटिश, विच वॉज बिल्ड बाई द इंग्लिश। हाउ डिड सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट दे बिल्ट, कैन एनी ऑफ यू कैन टेल मी हाउ डिड दे? वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड। सो सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड, ओके, सो इंग्लिश वॉट दे डिड, दे टुक मद्रास, दे टुक मद्रास फ्रॉम द किंग ऑफ चंद्रगिरी, ओके, द किंग ऑफ चंद्रगिरी, अंडरस्टूड। आफ्टर दे कैप्चर्ड दैट फोर्ट फ्रॉम द किंग ऑफ चंद्रगिरी एंड दे नेम्ड दैट फोर्ट एज सेंट जॉर्ज फोर्ट, गॉट इट? English took Madras from the king of Chandragiri and established a strong fort named St. George Fort. Yes? Any doubts? Very good. Yeah. I hope the concept is clear. I will tell about St. William Fort later. Just now, let me go with St. George Fort. Next. Who gave Bombay as an annual rent of 10 pounds a year to East India Company? Yes, very good. See, children, Bombay was under English, right? Bombay was under English, correct? At that time, what happened? Bombay, this, who is that fellow? Charles II. Yeah. Yeah, Charles II, the Prince of England, he gave rent of Bombay to East India Company as 10 pounds, 10 pounds. Per year, for every year, he was giving 10 pounds to East India Company. Understood? Charles II, the Prince of England, gave the annual rent of 10 pounds a year to East India Company. Any doubts? Someone is unmuted your mic. Can you please mute it? Yeah. Understood the concept? Next. Can you name the presidencies of the British? Which were the presidencies of the British? Very good. Bombay, Madras and Calcutta. These were the presidencies of the British. Next, when was French East India Company started? 1664. Where did the French establish their first factory? Very good. French also established their first factory at Surat. English started their first warehouse? Yes. Very good. It is Surat. Can you tell me who is Dupleix? Very good. He was the Governor General of French, or he was a French Governor General. Okay. Next question. Why did the Portuguese and Dutch withdraw from India by 18th century? Why they came out? By 18th century, they left their territory because they are unable to withstand the competition from the French and English. That is the reason. Understood? See, something, if they are coming out, means definitely they cannot meet to the competition. That is the reason they came out. Understood? Now, in your syllabus, there is no Carnatic Wars. Am I right? Yeah, no, we are not going to study anything related to Carnatic Wars. Next question. When was Battle of Plassey was fought? Battle of Plassey was fought in the year? Children, believe or not, this is very, very, very important question. The Battle of Plassey was fought in 1757. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Yes. I got it. Now, can you tell me when was the Battle of Buxar fought? No, this is important. Yeah, this is important. Who brought in dual government concept? Dual government? Yeah, very good. Robert Clive. Mention the cunning policies of the British. Which was the cunning policy? Dhoka Desi. Mute your mic. The cunning policies of the British were subsidiary alliance, and doctrine of lapse. And doctrine of lapse. Okay. Next question. Who gave Kora and Allahabad to Madras? Who gave Kora and Allahabad to Marathas? Who gave these places to Marathas? Very good. Shah Alam II. Shah Alam II gave Kora and Allahabad to Marathas. Got it? Can you name some Indian species which are having a very great demand in Europe? Pepper, ginger, cardamom. Can you tell me which was, excuse me, Indian species had a great demand in Europe is this? Can you tell me which was having very great demand in India, European products? Europe products, we had a very great demand. We were taking more those products. Which were those? Do you know? Horses. Horses. Wine. Understood? We were buying horses from Europe. We were buying wine from Europe. Understood. So these are the products which we are taking from those people. We had a very great demand for this. Got it, man? Very good. Next, which is the first trading center of Dutch in India? Which is the first trading center of the Dutch in India? Dutch started their first trading center. Very good, Surat. See, man, Surat, man. See your face only. So you're keeping your face and you're asking other face, man. See, let you take British or let you take French or let you take Dutch. I don't know what they kept in Surat. All were falling there only. But at least they made one thing good, man. Because one name only, no, so we can remember. Let it be any question, only one name. If it was three names, then it was difficult. Remember three different names. No, man. They also had, but in a textbook they have not given about that information. Okay, what is there? How much is there? Let me study according to that. Enough. Any doubts? Very good. Next is I think we have covered everything, right? Now, one more question is, no, they started, see here, they invented new spirit to India, right? Yeah, when they have invented new spirit to India, they invented still more number of things. Can you tell me which are those? Yes, they invented these all things. When they started finding the new spirit, they also invented these things. Correct? Yeah. Then what else is there? Who gave Diwani rights? Diwani rights. Alam, again. Who gave all rights over Bengal? Very good question. I was expecting same question from you people. See you. Okay. Because in this chapter, this is only the question is left out. Okay, anyways, Battle of Buxar. See, actually, what happened in Battle of Buxar is, see. Now, if you want to understand Battle of Buxar, you should know Battle of Plassey. See, everything is interrelated with each other because someone has fought at that time. No, again, they have to take revenge, right? Yeah, it is like that. Anyways, I'll try to explain you Battle of Buxar. Now, Mir Qasim declared himself as the independent king. Now, suddenly, if I use the word Mir Qasim, no, sir, you may get a doubt. Sir, who is Mir Qasim came now? Correct? So only we have to study from Carnatic Wars. Okay, but now you remember only. Yes, man. That is the beauty of your syllabus, man. What is important that they have deleted? Next, see ya. Even I have also done the same thing. Even I have taught Carnatic Wars also. In my class, man. Yeah, see ya. And you can see the video also, it's there in the YouTube channel based on that. Already, I have made the video also. Okay, anyways. Mir Qasim, he declared that he is going to become the independent king. He is going to become the independent king. As soon as he declared that he is going to become the independent king, then what happened? They started misusing the dastaks. Misuse of dastaks. Wait, man, I'm telling. Yeah. License. License is known as dastakas. Okay. They started misusing dastakas and he declared that the business is duty free in Bengal. Business is duty free means no tax. No tax. As soon as Mir Qasim declared that he is the independent king of Bengal. Bengal territory. No, he said that no, I'm the in charge. No, I am the independent king of Bengal. And he started misusing the dastakas and he started that no one have to pay any tax to anyone. Do you think that British will keep quiet? No, correct? No. At that time, the Indians competed against British in all spheres of business. As soon they said that, see, children, actually, one interesting concept is there. At that time, throughout India, oi. Throughout India, Britishers captured almost all the territories except Bengal. Bengal is the only place which was very difficult for them to manage because Bengal was a traditional place where we can see all the types of peoples were living. Let it be you take Hindus or Muslims, all the both the majorities of peoples were there in the Bengal, and there was a unity between them. There was a unity. That is what the only reason Britishers cannot able to rule that particular territory. Understood? समझ में बेटा? हाँ, ब्रिटिशर्स उस जगह भी उन्होंने कैप्चर करे, लेकिन बंगाल एक ही ऐसी जगह थी जो उनके अंडर में नहीं आया. क्यों कर को बोले तो उधर हिंदूज और मुस्लिम्स के अंदर यूनिटी थी, तो ब्रिटिशर्स को उन्होंने अंदर आने नहीं दिए. दे डिडंट अलाउ ब्रिटिशर्स टू कम इनसाइड. नाउ एज सून ही डिक्लेयर्ड दैट to from today onwards Bengal is completely free of tax, then the Indians started competing against the British in all spheres of business, due to which the British trade was suffered considerably. समझ में आ बेटा? उसके बाद सबको भी अच्छा मौका मिल गया ना, इंडियंस को अच्छा प्रॉफिट कमाने लगे, जिससे ब्रिटिशर्स को लॉस होना शुरू हो गया. एग्जाम्पल यू टेक, दिस इज ब्रिटिश शॉप एंड दिस इज इंडियन शॉप. Understood. Same price. Even British also, some other place they have to pay little, let it be some amount of tax to someone. But Indians are not, no need to pay any tax, so they are selling the product in a small amount compared to British amount. British is what they are selling the cunningness का मतलब धोखा देना. Cunningness मतलब कि धोखा देना भी बोल सकते हैं. समथिंग लाइक लेट मी से ओके एग्जाम्पल दे विल टेल एक्सक्यूज मी वन मिनट. या सो हियर द इंडियंस कॉम्पिटेड अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिश इन ऑल स्पीयर्स ऑफ बिजनेस द सो दैट वॉट हैपन द ब्रिटिश ट्रेड सफर्ड कंसिडरेबली. देन द ब्रिटिश स्टार्टेड अपोजिंग द नवाब. देन द ब्रिटिश वॉट दे डिड दे स्टार्टेड अपोजिंग नवाब. बिकॉज ऑफ यू वी आर गेटिंग लॉस. बिकॉज ऑफ यू वी आर गेटिंग लॉस इन अवर बिजनेस. अंडरस्टूड? अंडरस्टूड द पॉइंट चिल्ड्रन? या आफ्टर दैट ब्रिटिश वॉट दे डिड नो आफ्टर दैट ब्रिटिश वॉट दे डिड दे रिमूव्ड मीर कासिम एंड दे मेड मीर जाफर. ही इज एक्चुअली कॉल्ड एज ए ब्रिटिश पोपेट. ओके दे मेड मीर जाफर एज द नवाब ऑफ बंगाल. अंडरस्टूड? नो हु बिकेम द नवाब ऑफ बंगाल? मीर जाफर. या दे डिथ्रोन्ड मीर कासिम एंड दे ब्रॉट मीर जाफर एज द नवाब ऑफ बंगाल. देन वॉट हैपन्ड? मीर कासिम, डू यू थिंक दैट मीर कासिम विल कीप क्वाइट? मीर कासिम ही विल कीप क्वाइट? ही इज ए किंग. इनडायरेक्टली और डायरेक्टली दे रिमूव्ड हिम बाय सम अदर डिफरेंट सोर्सेस बाय पुटिंग हिम सम ब्लेम्स ऑल दोस थिंग्स दे रिमूव्ड हिम फ्रॉम द थ्रोन एंड दे मेड मीर जाफर. नो, मीर कासिम बिकेम एंग्री. ही बिकेम एंग्री एंड ही सेड दैट आई एम गोइंग टू फाइट अगेंस्ट यू. आई एम गोइंग टू ऑर्गेनाइज वॉर अगेंस्ट यू. अंडरस्टूड? देन मीर कासिम सेड दैट आई एम गोइंग टू ऑर्गेनाइज ए वॉर अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिश. अंडरस्टूड? नो, दिस वॉर वॉट मीर कासिम डिड द वॉर विथ इंग्लिश, दिस वॉर इज नोन एज बैटल ऑफ बक्सर. वॉट इट? कॉन्सेप्ट इज क्लियर? Did you understood the story why this Battle of Buxar was held? Because of what purpose? See, someone if they do good, no, other people will not see to that. They are not satisfied. They will be not happy. See, he was doing so much good things. He started, he declared that don't no need to put tax. You people keep your profit like that. People were happy, but Britishers were not happy. So this war was held in the year 1764. Any doubts? Now, what were the outcomes? What were the outcomes due to this war? Or what were the results? Outcomes are nothing but results. So, what were the results of this Battle of Buxar? Or the Battle of Buxar had played the British to get many benefits. Because of Battle of Buxar, British were profitable actually. Children, remember what Battle of Buxar in angry Mir Qasim did the Battle of Buxar with the British. But actually, indirectly, it was profitable for English. This war has brought profit to English. How? Let me see. This is in, we discuss in the results. So actually, what happened? As soon he declared the war, all Diwani rights they secured. Britishers secured all the Diwani rights. All the Diwani rights. Diwani rights means collection of tax. Diwani rights means what? Collecting tax. This all. Yeah, this all Diwani rights has gone under whom? English. Understood? And all the rights of over Bengal, all the rights, rules, regulations, everything was gone under English. Now, because of this war, in this war, actually, Mir Qasim failed. Mir Qasim, due to this war, Mir Qasim has to surrender his territories. He gave all Diwani rights to British. And he gave all the rights over Bengal to British, and also he has to give a compensation that is rupees 50 lakhs of that time. He has to pay 50 lakh for Nawab. Nawab means for Mir Jafar. For Mir Jafar, he has to pay 50 lakh. Understood? As war expenditure. Yeah, that is their child. That is actually comes under your Battle of Plassey also. Understood. Yeah. But just let me give simple points enough. No need to go with complicated things. That's the reason. Understood. Actually, these three peoples fought together with in Battle of Buxar. Correct? No. This trio, three peoples, they fought against the English. Yeah, three peoples together fought against the English. Okay. But here, due to this 50 lakh, excuse me, mute your mic. Mute your mic. Mute your mic. They got 50 lakh from Nawab. So Mir Qasim has to pay 50 lakh as a war expenditure to British. And also the entire administration of Bengal, the complete administration of Bengal has went to British. And now, see, they secured, British secured all the right of revenue collection through dual government. They started ruling dual government. Dual government means actually East Bengal and West Bengal. Understood? Because they don't want unity between Hindus and Muslims. They want to divide them. They are telling against Hindus to Muslims and Muslims to Hindus. They want this system. So they brought dual government system, but actually it was not successful. Let me see later on about that. Understood? Anyways, now who did this? Robert Clive. Robert Clive started this dual government system so that we can rule even Bengal also. Actually, their aim was that, but it was not successful. Anyways, it made the British the real holders of the power of Bihar, Bengal, and Odisha. And even Awadh remained under their control. Awadh place also went under the British control. So these are the actual profits what they got due to Battle of Buxar. Any doubts? You understood what Battle of Buxar and what were the results of Battle of Buxar? Very good. Yeah. Now you need to remember one more thing. Which were the warehouses of the you have to remember which were the warehouses name, means remember the names, okay? And can you tell me who came first to India for trade? Came Portuguese. They may ask you this chronological order. Please mute your mic. Mute your mics. First is Portuguese, then Dutch, then English, and then French. Remember this order. And also, please mute your mics. And remember, the Dutch, English are British, and French warehouses. Where were there names of these warehouses? Yeah, names of these all Dutch, English, French. Got it? Understood? Concept is clear? Okay. So this is the end of this chapter, and yeah, this is the end of this chapter, Advent of Europeans to India. Concept is clear? Everyone? Yes, children. If you have liked this class in your YouTube channel, you can like and you can share.